I could have helped her. That was my cross to bear. But we shouldn't have even been there in the first place. For that, my cold-hearted bastard of a father was to blame. But I never told him. I never faced him in life. This was my chance. My only chance. I could already hear him coming in the distance. Later, under the ice, he would scare the hell out of me. But he would also light the way of my memories. Seeing her again, her face, her hair, it was a comforting memory. I was a lucky dad compared to my father. Oh, yes. Clever girl. Sophia had shielded herself in a closet. It tumbled over and she got trapped. Somehow that had been enough to save her from the ire of the tornado. But I wouldn't know that until many years later. My father identified the body. Call me morbid, but I feel that people need to see a corpse, or else they will cling to a false sense of hope. I didn't see her corpse, so I clung to that false sense of hope. While the concept of death didn't escape me, I was still a child full of fanciful notions. Maybe if I wished really, really hard. Or maybe if my father was wrong, and the body hadn't been Sophia's, but no. What I truly believed for so long was that he was lying to me about it, that she was alive somehow, and my own father had taken her away from me. I did confront him with that, loudly and often. I saw nothing but his anger. No wonder I broke him in this world. I already had long ago. Thank you.